Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to run Python program in your favorite Visual Studio Code editor. So let's begin. Now to run Python program in your favorite Visual Studio Code editor, you need to download two software. One is Python and another is Visual Studio Code itself. So for that, just simply go to your favorite browser and in the address bar, just simply type Python download, then enter. And then you'll be seeing this www.python.org is basically our first search result. So just, you know, simply click on download the latest version of Python. And this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of Python. In here, you'll be getting is download Python 3.9.6 button. So just, you know, simply click on that. And this will, you know, going to start downloading our Python. If you just, you know, simply click on show all, you can clearly see our Python is now currently downloading. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. So in this way, you can easily download your Python. I'll be showing you the installation step, so you don't need to worry that. So I'll show you that, but before that, let us first download our Visual Studio Code as well. So for that, just, you know, simply type Visual Studio Code. And this will, you know, going to show you this Visual Studio Code as a first search result. So just, you know, simply click on that. And this will, you know, going to redirect you to this official site of Visual Studio Code. In here, you'll be getting a button called download for Windows. So just, you know, simply click on that. And this will, you know, going to show you thanks for downloading and our downloading is started. Since I have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And let us first minimize our browser. And if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see we have rightly downloaded our Python 3.9.6 and our Visual Studio Code itself, right? So now it's time to install our software. So first I'm going to install Python. So for that, just, you know, simply double click on it. And this will, you know, going to show you our Python installation wizard. In here, you need to just, you know, simply check this add Python 3.92 path. That's the most important step. So do check that. Do not forget that. Okay, so do check that. And then you need to also click on this custom installation. And in here, just, you know, keep everything as a default and then just simply click on next. And now you need to also check this install for all users, right? And you need to also check this add Python to environment variables. That's a very important step. Do check these two, these basically five options, right? If it's not checked, then do check that manually, right? And then just simply click on install. And now it will ask you for administrative privileges. Before then, just simply click on yes. And you can clearly see our installation has been, you know, rightly began. So this is just a 24 MB file. It won't be taking that much of time. So maybe at most 1 to 2 minutes. So what we're doing is I'll be coming back after installing Python 3.9.6. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see our Python has been rightly installed. So it is currently telling that setup was successful. So just, you know, simply click on close. And if you just, you know, simply go to our command prompt, and in here, if you just simply type Python space dash dash version, then enter, you can clearly see our Python 3.9.6 has been, you know, rightly installed, right? So let us first cancel it. So now it's time to install our Visual Studio Code. So for that, just, you know, simply double click on it to basically install our Visual Studio Code. And you can clearly see our license agreement has been, you know, rightly open. So do check this, I accept the license agreement, and then just simply click on next. And then do check this create a desktop shortcut icon, and then also check add to path. Right, and then just simply click on next. And now it's saying that it's ready to be installed. So just, you know, simply click on install, and it will, you know, going to start installing our Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So this might take, you know, again a couple of minutes. So what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after installing Microsoft Visual Studio Code. Yeah. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see our Microsoft Visual Studio Code has been, you know, rightly installed. So just, you know, simply click on finish to basically launch our Microsoft Visual Studio Code. And this will, you know, going to start launching our Microsoft Visual Studio Code. And you can clearly see it has, you know, rightly launched, right? So now you need to just, you know, simply go to file, then, you know, simply click on this open folder. So our open folder window has been, you know, directly open. Now you need to just, you know, simply click on documents and now new folder. So what we are doing is we are going to, you know, write a simple Python code snippet. So for that, let us first create a Python procs for our Python programs and then just simply select that folder. And this will, you know, going to select our Python procs folder over here. You can clearly see it has, you know, right selected. Now it's time to install one plugin. So for that, just, you know, simply select this extension and in here just simply type Python and you'll be getting this Python link over here. So that is basically developed by Microsoft, so it's totally safe. Just, you know, simply click on install to basically install our Python extension in our Visual Studio Code. So for that, you need to have an active internet connection right throughout this installation, because this plugin is actually going to be fetched from internet and it, you know, going to be installed over here, right? So for that, you need to have an active internet connection so that it will, you know, going to able to complete that process. This might take some time. You can see this is taking some time, so maybe, you know, couple of minutes or even more. So again, what I'll be doing is I'll be coming back after, you know, completion of this process. Yeah, so we'll come back and now as you can clearly see, our Python has been directly installed. So our extension has been successfully installed. So just simply go back to our Explorer and then you need to just simply click on this plus icon to create a new file. So let's give a file name as a prog.py. Why py? Because we are going to write a simple Python program and for Python the file extension is .py, right? So just, you know, simply write that much and you can clearly see our prog.py file has been, you know, rightly opened over here. And now you need to just simply write a simple hello world code snippet in Python. So let's, you know, write print hello world, sorry, hello world, yeah. And then you need to just simply go to file again, then save, right? And now if you just simply click on this run button, you can clearly see this hello world has been rightly shown in our console. So this hello world, right? So in this way you can easily install Python and Microsoft Visual Studio Code in Windows 10 operating system, and you can easily run any Python program in Microsoft Visual Studio Code itself. This Microsoft Visual Studio Code itself build this beautiful plugin called Python, which basically also, you know, create this run button over here. If you see over here, this run button is also going to be installed with that plugin, right? So that's a very beautiful, you know, feature Microsoft developed. So it is always recommended to code in Microsoft Visual Studio Code itself, right? So in this way you can easily run any Python program in Microsoft Visual Studio Code. So that is basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like and also do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.